Is that what you deal for, just
happened? Yeah, I mean, thoroughly deserved. You know, he signed a contract at the beginning of summer or something.
March.
March, yeah. That's the beginning of summer, isn't it? Well, it isn't Brighton, I don't know what I mean.
You're still waiting on that.
Yeah, so, I mean, he thoroughly deserves it, you know. He's playing every week, he's starring most weeks. He's applied himself, and you know, I've been here a year now, and you know, when I came, he was one of the ones I targeted, and he's done everything I've asked of him, you know. So, you know, we're delighted with him, and you know, I'm delighted for him because he's now starting to progress, you know, not just on the field, but you know, off the field.
Yeah. Two new contracts in such a short space of time, is that with a view to try and protect him to the club in case of?
Well, I mean, the contract he had, you know, to be fair, did that anyway. And also, you know, we have compensation rights and that. So we're pretty much protected. So, yeah, of course it is, but to a degree. But it was more really about, you know, Chris himself getting what he deserves to be playing every week with the other boys, you know, on a level with them. And, you know, and that's what he's getting. So it's good.
What's his potential?
He's just got to keep improving. You know, I still think there's aspects of his play that he can work really hard on. At the moment, you know, he's most effective on the outside. I still think he can develop his game in a kind of 360 sort of basis, you know, where he can play in the centre of the park, you know, be a great asset in there. He needs to add some goals. You know, he's got goal potential, I believe. I see him at training. So I think he does have to add some goals to his game. But, you know, he's still young and he's still working at it and he's still developing. So hopefully all that will improve.
You know, when we speak to him, he's a nice guy. Is that as well? He's got the right sort of character to...
My players are all nice guys. I think he's got enthusiasm. He's still got that freshness about him, you know, which you see in his play. And I hope he can retain that as long as possible until he develops into this sort of accomplished player. I mean, I thought on Saturday, even though he's starting to look a much more mature player, and not just physically, but, you know, the way he's thinking about the game and his decision-making is starting to look a bit more, you know, convincing than it was, you know. So he definitely is improving.
How do you explain the turnaround in fortunes from the next game to Ross County?
Well, it wasn't really a turnaround in fortunes. It was a better result, you know. You know, we had played well against Hearts, we played well against Celtic. We hadn't had good results, of course, but, you know, because of the nature of the opposition, you know, the fancied teams, it tends not to affect your confidence quite as much, the results. The Inverness game was neck and neck until the last half hour, and it was like, I described it at the time, it was like popped a balloon, and that was hugely disappointing. So it was just making sure that we were, you know, a bit more robust than that mentally. And we started the game really, really well. We got the first goal, which is very, very important. The other thing was it wasn't too long. It was only a couple of days, you know, so it wasn't like a week, or it wasn't an international break and we had 2 weeks to fester. You know, it was like, in the next day, come on, hey, we can do better than that. You are better than that. Let's go on, mate. Go up, train, have a laugh, get together again, go out and batter, you know, to the best of our abilities, Ross County, you know. So, you know, that helped as well, just that short time span.
You see, Dundee, obviously, like, a welcome result weekend.
Mm-hmm.
That's sort of thing that could...
Yeah, Dundee aren't any different from any rest is, you know. You know, I've seen Dundee play really poorly, but I've also seen them play well. I've seen Inverness play poorly, I've seen them, you know, play really well. You know, Ross County, they're all the same. Thistle, I was at the Thistle-Ross County game last week, you know. And trust me, there'll be a lot of managers sitting who would say, I've seen Motherwell play absolute rubbish, but I've seen them play well. So we're all in the same boat. So we have got to go into every game expecting that whoever we're playing will play well, you know, that they're capable of it, and that day they will play well. So that way we won't be taken by surprise. So they have that in them. They're at home. First goals, you know, are really important, you know. So, you know, we've got to guard against that, because that would give them a huge lift and, you know, sort of galvanise them in front of their own support. So we've got to try and maybe, if we could get the first goal, that would give them a problem.
You'd be much happier going into another break on the back of 2 runs.
Yeah, it feels, I think, it allows me to leave it behind in a sense. You know, I'm not dwelling on anything that's happening here when I'm away with the international team when we've had a result. You know, that is absolutely true. I used to see it with Stuart, you know. Stuart used to come in, and if it was in the back of a poor result, we're all, you know, avoiding them for you know, the first 12 hours, you know. But, you know, if you go in a positive, you know, note, it helps my mentality there, but also allows me kind of leave this for the 6 or 7 days that I have to.
What's your take on it, on what's been happening this week with the row about the poppies for the
group? Well, the sort of intimate politics of it, you know, in terms of why they view it the way they are, I've not really, you know, studied that very hard. I mean, I wear a poppy. I'm someone who, you know, has a great respect for the armed forces. When I see the guys, I travel in the airport a lot, and when I see them, I have occasionally just said something to them. You know, I feel obliged to, because I think they do an amazing job, and a job that none of us would have the bottle to do, most of us. So I think they deserve support, I really do, and I think it's a very British thing, and I think it doesn't reflect on any other, I don't think it's disrespectful to anybody else. I think it's something that is traditional, and I know that time changes and traditions have to change, sometimes have to be tempered with a wee bit, but I think the poppy thing is just a quiet, sort of respectful way of recognising everybody that's made a contribution over all the conflicts that we've had. It's not just about any particular group of people. I think it recognises everyone.
Statements coming out from FIFA last night, it seemed to be that they're starting to align that this isn't going to be allowed. The SFL said that they're going to join the FA along with some sort of being an armband or something like that. But the suggestion for FIFA is that all options in terms of punishments would remain on the table, including points penalties. I mean, that would seem like a bit of an overreaction for what is something that's supposed to be, as you say, tribute to people
of
ultimate sacrifice.
You know, like I say, I've not studied the intimate politics of it, so I don't want to go that deep in here. And my personal feeling is I'd like to be able to wear a poppy.
Are there not other ways that you could mark respect for the armed forces by a presence on the pitch before or after proceeds, etc.?
I'm sure there's 100 ways. You know, my point would be that I think that we should, in some way, show respect. This has always been a traditional point of doing it, and I would be delighted to do whatever I'm asked to do to do that. What it is, I've got no idea. I thought that the poppy was fine, but you know, if they say no, then we'll look for some other way, definitely.
Precedent has been set to wear poppies in the past, hasn't it?
Well, yeah, we all wear poppies. Most people do, I think. But you know, if we can't and we have to do something else, we'll do what's necessary. But I think, you know, we should show that point of respect that we've always done. You know, I mean, I go back over the years, and you know, I've seen this, you know, training, you know, stopping, you know, and having that 2 minute silence or that. So, you know, we all recognise. You know, we're all good grandparents. My dad's in his late 80s. You know, he was close to it. I mean, the scary thing for me is that, you know, I didn't realise it, but I was actually born something like 12 years after the war. You know. And, you know, for a long, long time, it seemed to me that the war was in the distant past. But in actual fact, no, I was born in 1957. And, you know, it's nothing. You know, I've been a manager for 25 years or something like that. You know, twice as long as the time it was before the war had ended, you know. So it wasn't that, you know, long before my time. So, you know, it's part of my recent history, or part of my history. So I think we should recognise that. Yeah.
Team news for the weekend?
Laz is fit, he's training this morning, barring setbacks, he should be able to be included, so yeah, everyone's fit.
Thank you.